Hello and welcome to Kemba Bushcraft, and welcome to my series Bushcraft for Mate to Set in Random Order. And this time it's about the letter B, because it's about Bannock and bread. So hang on. And what's the difference between a Bannock and a bread? Well, I'm sure there's many explanations out there and many thoughts about what the difference is, but for me, Bannock is something you can make quickly and only using a pan. While the bread, as you can see here in my previous video I made some weeks ago, I have a dough from home. You can use anything. You can buy an instant package that you only have to add water in, and you can make your own dough from the same way you are making when you're making breads. So, but I took that out with me in my camp and put it in my Zebraone. As you can see here, I have customized it's my Zebraone so it can fit a little piece of bread. And then I put it in the coals and let it bake for about 20 minutes, 18 to 20 minutes. And then I got a nice bread and it tastes delicious. It's also easy to make, but again, you have to have a sort of pot with you, perhaps a Dutch oven or some other thing that you can bake it in. A Bannock is easy to make. You only have to have a pan, and I have the ingredients with me today so I can show you how my Bannock is. And I give it a little twist, and I'll talk about that a little bit later. So now I'm going to make my dough from the ingredients I have with me, and I can tell you how it's done. So hang on. And here in my little bowl made of bamboo, I have 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 1/4 of teaspoon of salt, and 2 teaspoons of baking powder. And I blend it so that everything is nice. And then I put a little bit of oil in, about a tablespoon of oil, and then add some water so that the dough is going to be made here. A little bit at the time. It's not going to be a big portion, just for me, so I can eat this while I'm having my coffee. And it's very important that it's mixed good, and when the dough is beginning to be a little bit dry, I can use my fingers. And it's also a good idea to have a little bit extra flour if you by accident is coming too much water in it. So now I just have to mix it. So now it's almost finished. I guess there's a lot of stories how Bannock was invented and where it came from, but I have a story I think is possible, so I will tell you that. Back in the 70s and 80s, the Scottish bought some oat and cast iron pans back down in the fur trade days and introduced their quick bread, the Bannock. The First Nation put a twist on it, it's quick wet, and used ground corn, wheat, roots, and added berry to their version of this bread. Original people have used this to cook over a fire around a stick, but it is the berries I'm going to add now, and I have some blueberries here, and I just want to spread this out and add these blueberries. Yeah, and of course you decide how many it's going to be, and then I just roll it up and again mix it so that the blueberries is inside the dough. perhaps you can see it's going to be a little wet, so I'll add a little more flour. And mix it in. And I think this is going to be a nice bread. So now the next step is to make a fire and put on my pan and actually begin cooking this. It shall be on the pan, cook for about 15 minutes on each side, and then we hopefully have a nice piece of bannock. I could make my fire in my fire pit, but today I'm going to make it on this one. And actually, I got a new thing I would like to show you. This is my titanium bush box from Bushcraft Essential, and you all know it. I used that many, many times. And this little one I made myself. I can put the stove over and protect the ground a little bit. But these things I'm not going to use anymore, and I'll show you why. I got such one, yeah. Isn't that cool and old school from Bushcraft Essential? It is so nice, made of leather, very good quality. And inside here, there's this little multifunctional plate. And the stove fits nicely down here, like this, and down in this little bag of perch. Yeah. So, but beside this awesome leather bag, this one has a very nice function, because as you can see here, I can put my stove down in these, and then if there's any ashes falling down from this cracks here, it will hit down on this plate. And this plate is also made of titanium, so it's also very lightweight. So I'm very grateful that the Bushcraft Essential are giving me such a nice gift, so I can show you, my faithful subscribers, how this is gonna work. So today I'm going to make my bannock on this, my bush box with my new plate, multifunctional plate. And on my website, I have links for all these new items too. So now I will light this up. So hang on. And then I will cook it for about 15 minutes on each side. And plenty of oil. Thank you. Well, now it's finished. A little bit on the black sides, but that's okay. I like it crispy. Yeah. It is okay inside. Baked. I think the blueberries is making it a little bit wet inside. So it's more like a cake, and that's perfect for my coffee, and it tastes delicious. Very delicious. Now I'm just waiting for my coffee. Well, folks, this is all for now. Hope you enjoy this little video and my series Bushcraft from A to Z. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. Now I'm going home, edit my video and launch it sometime here this weekend. And today, the 16th of May, I actually have been married with my wife Gitte for 33 years. So it is our anniversary, and of course I'm going home and spend the rest of the evening with her and having some good thing to eat and some good wine, and I'm looking very much forward to that. And I hope you're having a nice weekend too, and hope to see you again on next one. Bye bye and take care.